is my brother moved out. So a little bit about me, I guess. I have two brothers. We're all quite old now. We're in our 20s. And he's the first one to actually move out of, like, the house kind of thing. Like, move from home. Like, move from living with his mum kind of thing. Did that the other day. And he's the one, though, that owns the PS3 in the house. And he kind of took that with him. So it was always my plan that if I was going to do Uncharted 3, I was going to buy myself a capture card and then go for that. By the way, before I get distracted, yeah, there's a staircase here. When I was playing earlier, I just totally did not see the staircase. Thought it was just some helicopters. Tried to drive the helicopters, couldn't, and then walked back the way I came thinking I'd missed something. No, there's a staircase, so you're going to come down here. But yeah, so he's kind of gone, and I can't really do that with the PS3 anymore, which sucks. Maybe I could buy one at some point or borrow it from him, or that would be an excuse to see him at his new place. I don't know. It's an interesting idea, though. Capture card I could probably afford, though, now that I've actually got a proper job. And I've not mentioned this in any videos, and I don't know why I've not mentioned it in any videos. Now may as well be the moment. I am a partner on YouTube. I don't know. You probably noticed. Which is cool. I don't know. I didn't really do it for the ads and stuff. I didn't want ads that much on there. The thing is, I've always kind of told myself, I might die here. I genuinely might die here. I had always had the opinion that I would not partner with YouTube unless I was earning enough from it, potentially, to live my life and do this full time. And then it would be worth it. But I had so many offers after starting to do Guild Wars 2 Daily. So many offers from so many different people. It was ridiculous. And I was just turning them all down. Eventually, the Game Station approached me. And they said that they'd seen the stuff I was doing. And they're obviously expanding and loads of people in the Game Station. And it's not some massive privilege to be with them as it might have been before. See, I'm kind of stuck in that thought process that it was, you know, a year ago on YouTube or 2 years ago on YouTube, where partners, you had to have really kind of good content and had to be really well respected kind of thing. And now it's like loads of people are partnered and people don't bat an eye when someone, you know, uploads a 2 minute video that's got, you know, a 1 minute advert on it or something. People are far more forgiving now. And I don't know, maybe I personally am not so forgiving. So yeah, I wasn't going to do it, but they said that they'd been watching me and that this guy approached me. I don't know how much I should really say, but and that I would be a good fit. And in the end, I was just like, you know what, screw it. So I did it. I am now a partner. I am earning money. Please let me know what the ads are like, because I've just gone with complete and utter defaults with the ads. Just, I don't want to deal with it. Some people start going spreadsheets, and I don't want my motivation with YouTube to just start being about money or anything. But I'm bringing that up because I was kind of quite nicely segued. Eat grenade, bitch. That did quite nicely segue into I can use that money, though, to maybe buy a capture card or a PS3 when it gets that much. I've not been paid from it, though, so I have no idea how much money I'll get or anything like that. But, you know, it could save up and eventually I'll be able to get a capture card or something. That would be quite cool. But, yeah, so there you go. I just feel a little bit obligated to actually mention that I'm now a partner because I simply hadn't done it. Right, we get a really cool cutscene here. People that didn't play Anniversary might not understand everything about it. Bit of a fight going on here. You can probably understand that. But just roll with it, okay? Just roll with it. It's not a big plot point. It's really not. Trust me. You'll be fine. By the way, I don't know whether to consider this. Yeah, bye-bye. That was the guy that knocked us out, by the way. So that's his kind of... I think that was the guy that knocked us out. I don't think he's a... Oh, does he come back in the story? I remember so little about the story of this. Really. I've still got to film daily. Right, so there has been a big explosion on the boat. Brilliant. The sprinklers are on. This isn't good. Right, okay. Oh, something very cool. The end of Legend. I mentioned something. Okay, I can't remember if I did a bonus episode or what. There are crates in that final fight with Amanda, okay? And on those crates, it said this. It said Natla. Natla, okay? Tomb Raider 1, the original game, the final boss of the game, was a woman called Natla, who was a woman that essentially was from Atlantis. She was like the queen, one of the queens. There was like two kings and a queen of Atlantis. That was the plot of the original Tomb Raider. Between Legend and Underworld, they released the remake to the first game, which was called Anniversary. And obviously, those crates at the end of Legend were hints because they said Natla, and everyone was like, oh, are they going to do a remake? And they ended up doing a remake. Now, we're playing Underworld, and we find these crates that say Natla again. And it turns out they actually combine the story of the remake of the first game into the story of Legend and Underworld, which is why it kind of gets a little bit more interesting there. Have I just gone back the wrong way? I think I have. But trust me, you don't need to know anything about that game or to have played very much of that game at all. So here we go. This is awesome. I love it. I'm going to shut up.
Damn, it's too small. Only Lara can use it now. Until I kill her. Even that won't unbind the artifact. We're taking on water. Damn it! We'll pick this up again later.
Hello, Amanda.
I'm very pleased to see you again, Lara. This specimen jar offers little in the way of amusement. So I've grown fond of watching Amanda suffer the effects of sharing your interests.
Jacqueline Nutter, you just don't know when to die.
A trait we have in common.
It was you who told Amanda about Avalon.
Our time is short, so choose your questions carefully.
What do you know about my mother?
The dais you and she found in Nepal, it's part of a travel network, so to speak. It took your mother to Avalon.
My father thought Avalon was below, but that's Niflheim. What's the Norse connection?
Ah, Richard found the wrong Norse underworld. Your mother didn't go to Niflheim. She went to Helheim.
Where is it?
I will tell you where it is, one day. But when that day comes, you'll need Thor's hammer to get inside. Perhaps you'll have better luck finding it than your father did.
What do you mean?
Your answer is on the west coast of Thailand. Send it parallel.
I don't know why I love that line, Seventh Parallel. That's just such a cool name for a place. Right, the story now does something ridiculous. Realm of the Dead. Hold on, journal entry unlocked, because things are about, shit's about to hit the fan, basically. Okay. Amanda Evert. This is why I haven't like explained too clearly until now, because they're here in the journal. Amanda Evert. Amanda has never forgiven me for believing she was dead and leaving her buried in the Peruvian... Peru, that's where it was. That's the place I was talking about earlier. Of the last queen of Tiwanaku. When I found out that she survived and later escaped, I wondered if I too could forgive myself. But our clash over the search for King Arthur's sword Excalibur dulled my guilt, and knowing now that Amanda played a role in what happened to my mother has squashed the feeling entirely. The only reason I let her live was to someday learn more of what she knows. But if her aim is to kill me outright, I might have to change that strategy. Now, I think there might be some actual canon story or something that was released between the two games that explain how we got from "Where the fuck is my mother?" shoot, 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 and like the start of this where she just seems to have let her go. But this seems a bit weird to me, not knowing if that story, if it does exist. Like, why did Lara just let her go? Like, she's like, oh, I let her live so she could tell me at a later date. Well, you had her at gunpoint, and she just told you about Avalon. Why didn't you... I mean, it just... there's a disconnect there. It annoyed me in the Halo series when they did that as well, but I know they for sure, definitely between the games, released stuff that talked about the time between them. Like, for example, the change between Halo 2 and 3, I really wanted just to pick up Halo 3 still on the ship kind of thing. And even the fact that it was a very short jump forward in time, that still kind of annoyed me. I don't know, games just annoy me when they do that. So that's Amanda, if you didn't watch or play Legend. And then we have Natla. Natla was the... and this, if you've only been watching my channel, you have no idea about any of this. So this is Natla, okay? Natla was the immortal queen of Atlantis. And more recently, she was a CEO of Natla Technologies. We met her in Anniversary. Somehow, she lost her connection with the powerful artifacts of her reign millennia ago. And recently began devoting her knowledge and intellect toward recovering it all from the ancient sites around the world. Her aim is to initiate what she calls the Seventh Age, of which I know nothing other than it would be a very bad turn for humanity. I buried her on a remote island, but apparently Amanda has dug her out and is keeping her prisoner as her own personal encyclopedia Atlantica. I hope Amanda understands that she's sitting on a time bomb, and that everything Natla tells her is filtered by her own agenda. Which is a totally point. So this was like the final boss of Anniversary. See, this is the weird thing. I wanted to LP Underworld, right, which is really the sequel to Legend. That's a massive spoiler, what I just told you about Natla for Anniversary, because you meet Natla at the start of Anniversary, and you don't know that she's this immortal from Atlantis, and I can almost hear you guys getting annoyed as I'm talking more. You don't know that what she's that, and then you're supposed to find out at the end of the game. It's this big all reveal. The truth is, though, that because Anniversary is a remake of the original game, the guys that developed it basically had the mentality that everyone already knew that spoiler anyway. They already knew the story. So Natla looks really alien. And a guy I actually watched LP Tomb Raider stuff has LP'd Anniversary himself. He actually LP'd Tomb Raider 1 from the original generation and Anniversary side by side. He did it. It was really, really cool. It's one of my favourite LPs. Anyway, one thing that really pissed him off was that Natla is so clearly an alien and a bad guy right from the start of Anniversary. So even though it's technically a spoiler, don't worry, you would catch on very, very quickly. If you were the kind of person that caught on that Vizier Kilbron was a bad guy in Guild Wars, then you would catch on Natla straight away in Anniversary. But anyway, yeah, so she was the bad guy. She was one of the queens of Atlantis. She's immortal. She knows a lot about the ancient world, and she is Amanda's prisoner right now. Don't forget, this thing here doesn't mention, don't forget, Amanda has got a pet. She's got a pet beast crazy thing that you see a lot of in Legend, and was the final boss of Legend. Anyway, right, so yeah, remember that explosion on the boat? And, you know, Amanda's just bailed. Yeah, things have kind of got a little bit worse here. Am I going the right way? Yes, I am. Good. All right, on my test run, I went the wrong way there. All right, so here we learn how to sprint, which is the same as moving fast underwater. I love this scene, by the way. Move, Lara. I absolutely love it. They're so cool. Another slow, quick time thing there. Very cool. The boat is slowly shifting. Wait, what? 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 See, in my test run, that almost killed me as well. How are you supposed to know about that? That's ridiculous. See, I can't even see my health. I don't have a health kit. Ugh. Come on. Put my bitch in. Let's go. Right, we'll move around this corner. Lara, you can do it. Good stuff. Right, now I'm going to wait here. There we go. See, how are you supposed to see that kind? Some people quite like that in games where it's like, oh, you fail on it the first time and now you figure out exactly what's happening next time. But that pisses me off. If you can't figure out the first time, then I kind of think it's a bit bad design. Anyway, we're kind of climb along these like little things here. This is quite cool. This really had me pumping the first time I played this. This was so awesome. Because I was so scared that I was about to, you know, die and the water was going to... I love that the scene was changing as I was running around too. Obviously, the music's pretty awesome. Come on, up we go. Yeah. I love how Lara makes everything look fancy anyway. Oh, brilliant. Right, then we get a ladder here. I don't know if you can actually be too late on this. I'd quite like to see what happens if I wait. Maybe that's not a good idea. Come on, up we go. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, shit. I don't know if those things coming down can actually hit you. I don't think I've ever been hit by them myself, but I wouldn't risk it if I were you. If you see one coming, then make sure you're not directly underneath it because you don't want it to knock you off. Come on, Lara. Up, 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 Lara. From the left, there you go. Oh yeah, and then you drop down onto this, which is a bit careful, careful, careful. You do get to do a lot more cool acrobatic stuff. I'm just getting, oh Jesus! But then, like some of the jumps are really weird. There we go. That's, in my opinion, is the end of level one. 1 hour and 30 minutes in. And this is ridiculous. This is batshit crazy. I don't know what they were thinking. This is unbelievable what they do now. Okay, this is the most ridiculous bit of storytelling I think I've ever seen. I mean, so ridiculous that I almost can't get my head around them thinking they could get away with it. Okay, alright, where do I start? Where do I start? Okay, wait. I should start when we see the end of level screen. I mean, did you guys just see that? Do you see what they did? What a crappy excuse that was for us to get that artifact back? So they obviously had introduced this thing that they wanted Lara to have the gauntlet first. Okay, hold on. According to that, Avalon and the Norse underworld of Helheim are one and the same. Entry is not possible without Mjolnir, the warhammer of the Norse god of thunder, Thor. Is this what my father was searching for in Thailand? Coastal Thailand, this is level 2. You actually get, like, as I say, you kind of get a bit of a loadout. Do we go for the jungle shorts or the jungle pants? See, I don't know. I like the way she looks in the pants, but I'm going to go shorts just because I don't call them pants. And here you go. This is their weapon system. As I say, it's not the same as in the first generation of Tomb Raider games, which is one of the things I most enjoyed. You get to choose kind of what weapon you want. We obviously already saw the spear gun. You always get the pistols. There's a tranquilizer gun. Which, what? See, I don't know. I'm not even 100% sure how these things are different at the moment. Maybe we'll go... Let's go shotgun. Come on, shotgun. You've always got to love shotgun. So you choose those. You choose the outfit. I think you still unlock different outfits and stuff, and you kind of get to pick. Because don't forget, you can revisit locations. But I don't think the outfit system is as extensive as it was in Legend. Maybe it's different. Anyway, this is Thailand. I need to be careful not to forget.
None of the ruins are visible from down here. And if Father did explore this site, I see no sign of it yet.
I still don't see how Thailand is connected to Vikings, or ruins under the Meta Hell, even Avalon for that matter.
Helheim, Zip. Various myths use different names, but they all apply to the same remnants of the ancient world.
One of those remnants is still alive. I would hate to be Amanda if Natla ever gets free. I would hate to be any of us.
Right, so yeah, Thailand, absolutely brilliant. Before, let me finish my rant, okay? They obviously had this thing with the gauntlet that Lara needed to get to it first so that it would be bound to her so that Amanda wouldn't be able to do it. Why they wanted to do that at the moment isn't going to be clear to us, but fine, whatever. Okay, they needed to establish that. So they give it to her, and then they immediately realize, shit, Lara doesn't know anything about this. We need to get into the hands of someone who does know something about it. So they're like, right, we'll take it off of Lara. Fine, we'll have some mercenaries take it off of her. We'll give it to Amanda. And then we'll have Lara have a scene where she gets to talk to Natla for some reason, and Amanda or her thugs don't do anything about it. And she gets to talk about that for a while. And then they establish that Amanda can't use it herself. They obviously needed to establish that story, so they need to get this artifact very quickly into someone else's hand to establish only Lara could use it at this point until she was murdered, right? And then they need to give it back to Lara. So they had this thing that they knew they'd written into the story that they had to do, and they're such a cop-out. They're like, alright, so now the boat's sinking. Oh, but we've got to get somehow... Amanda needs to give away this artifact to Lara. What are we going to do? Okay, we'll have Lara jumping out of the sinking boat. We'll have the helicopter that clearly took off ages ago still around. We'll have Natla's cage mysteriously missing from it. But we'll have Amanda randomly hanging off of a rope from the bottom of the helicopter. Why is she hanging from the rope? I don't know. Why isn't she already in the helicopter itself? And then we'll have Lara take a random pot shot at Amanda. Amanda be stupid enough to throw the thing in the ocean. And then Lara be able to dive down next to the sinking boat with all the debris and fire and everything all over the place. Get down into the water to find it and grab it and get it back. I mean, what a cop-out. What an absolute crazy thing they did there. I just couldn't help but watch that. Even when I first played it with my mouth slightly open, like... they ended up resorting to do stuff like that. Anyway, I hope it was super cool and super actiony and you guys loved it. This is Thailand. This is the place that I mentioned earlier that when I first got to this, man, in the game, I thought this was beautiful. Unbelievable. The graphics here just absolutely blew me away. And looking at it now, I don't know. I mean, it's not as impressive as I once thought it was. The water still looks brilliant, but I mean, I've seen games with better graphics than this water now. It's interesting how it does that to you, doesn't it? I remember posting on Guild Wars 2 Guru at one point. We were talking about the kind of environments we wanted to see in Guild Wars 2, and I cited this as one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen in a game, and I kind of wanted the Maguma Coast to look like it. Obviously, it looks nothing like this. Anyway, we've got a cave over there. This is all really for... I don't know. I kind of want to keep going. Should we have a bit of a swim? Is the journal updated at all since that? Yeah, it is. All right, Thailand expedition, what are we doing? I don't know the extent to which my father worked with Natla or how much truth there is in what she said, but she acts only out of self-interest, so any help or information she provides is because she wants the same thing I want. I can therefore assume that whether my father explored this site or not, there is likely something here that will get me closer to Avalon. So for now, even though she's our enemy, really... and she wants terrible things for the world, as far as we can see. As Lara said in that previous journal, she doesn't actually know exactly what Natla wants. This seventh kingdom, is it what? Not the seventh kingdom, what did she call it? Natla. Her aim is to initiate what she calls the seventh age, of which I know nothing other than you don't like the idea of it. So we don't know fully what Natla's about. But she's helping us, even though she probably has bad intentions at some point. But yeah, so next time, guys, next week, I'll see you in a week, I guess. This will have slowly been uploading. And yeah, next time we'll be in Thailand, and we'll continue on with through this stuff. So yeah, thanks very much, guys, for watching. If you did make it here, let me know what you've been thinking of the LP. Hello, Mr. Shark. Do you want to kill me? See, now, obviously, you have a choice to make as well when you start the levels. Do you want to have a weapon that's good for underwater stuff, or two weapons that are good for land? I know particularly that this level's got a lot of land-based stuff, so it was a good idea to go with the shotgun, I think. But yeah, so yeah, let me know what you think. I'll hopefully, you know, ease into it. We've got lots to talk about, lots of stuff to do. And really, this is me LPing for a while. After this is done, because the game, as I said, isn't particularly long, Might be able to play Diablo 3 with Magical Mike. It might be like a collab thing, which could be quite cool if we end up doing that. Anyway, yeah, I've still got Guild Wars 2 Daily to film, and it's like 10 o'clock at night by this point, so yeah. I guess I'll see you guys next time. Rambling. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Have a nice week. Have a nice life. See you later.